Mighty God, I honor you this morning. I glorify you for who you are. You are the great God of all the ends of the earth, the God that sitteth on the circles of the earth, the God of all flesh. Hallelujah. Father God, I honor you, O God, for you are great and great, greatly to be praised. Hallelujah, Jesus. My heart rejoices this morning, O God, for who you are, not for what you have done, but for who you are. Father God, right now, let the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable in thy sight, O Lord, my strength and my redeemer. Amen and amen. This morning, our devotion is entitled Editing Our Lives. Editing Our Lives. Praise God. And we'll be looking at Hebrews chapter 12, verse 1 and 2. And we'll be reading from the NLT version of the Bible. Therefore, since we are surrounded by such a huge crowd of witnesses to the life of faith, let us strip off every weight that slows us down, especially the sin that so easily trips us up. And let us run with endurance the race God has set before us. We do this by keeping our eyes on Jesus, the champion who initiates and perfects our faith. Because of the joy awaiting him, he endured the cross, disregarding its shame. Now he is seated in the place of honor beside God's throne. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Glory to God, you know. And it's a familiar verse of scripture this morning that says, lay aside the sin and weight that so easily beset us. Let us edit our lives this morning. The scriptures make reference to the path that we as believers are called to walk. The references that are made gives the picture that tells the story of things that might seem impossible, like Matthew 19, verse 24, and Mark 10, verse 25. It is easier for a camel to go through the eye of a needle than for a rich man to enter into the kingdom of God. Now, he's not saying that a rich man cannot enter the kingdom of God, but he's just saying, it's showing us the difficulty it might have, the person might have, because with your riches and many gains, because a lot of people, when they get to a certain status in life, they tend to put their trust in their substance. But the word of God says a man's life is not consist of the things that he has attained in this world. Hallelujah. We thank God this morning that we who know him know the value and the worth of our lives in Christ Jesus. But I said this morning that all things are possible with God if we only can believe God and take him at his words. Hallelujah. We are called to be witnesses, and that essentially means we need to go, we need to have our faith on display. Live out our faith. We got to live out our faith. And that's one thing I keep saying. I want to live out my faith. Now, faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. So my faith cannot be seen, but I'm told that I have to display it. I have to live it out. I have to let it manifest in the physical realm. That which I know to be true in the spiritual, I have to work it in the natural. Praise the Lord. You see, every morning we get up, we are given another chance to edit our lives. Edit your life? What do you mean, you might ask? We are given a chance to make amends, to ask for forgiveness, to be forgiven, and to realize that nothing is so important to make us miss the mark, to miss heaven this morning. There's nothing in this life that should be that important to keep you from missing heaven. Each day we get up, we need to keep pressing. The word of God tells us in Matthew 7, verses 13 to 14, enter ye in at the straight gate. For wide is the gate and broad is the way that leadeth to destruction, and many there be which go in thereat. Because straight is the gate and narrow is the way which leadeth unto life, and few there be that find it. Have you ever realized that anything that is good for us seems like it's elusive, like we're not pursuing it? But the things that seems to make our flesh feels good. That's what we go after. Anything that has to do with our spirit, with our spiritual life, is like we do not invest in it like we're supposed to. If you're a child of God, taking money and investing in your spiritual life should not be a hard thing. The word of God said, money answereth all things, but it's the love of money that is the root of all evil. One thing I tell God to do is to deliver me from money. You see, when money is not a God in your life, it'd be easy for you to do what you need to do to get to that place where you need to get to. Many times I find when there are a lot of choices, I personally get a little bit confused and discombobulated because I start second guessing myself. Because if there's many choices, you're like, okay, am I making the right decision? Is this what God really wants me to do? And when the Spirit of God is speaking, because there's so many different choices, you tend to want to do the things that make your flesh feel good, where others will see and say, wow, you know, you get the accolades because it's on display, it's bright and everybody can see it. But the Bible says that is those comely parts that nobody can see, they have the most importance. The things that we do in secret, those are the things that are most important. Hallelujah. So I start second guessing myself, wondering if I'm making the right decisions. On the straight and narrow path, there are not many choices. It is doing it God's way or no way at all. Once we surrender our lives to Christ, we are given time and time again to get it right. You ever notice that sometimes you go through a certain patch in life? It's like you're repeating the same situation, the same circumstances, because you might have failed. God told you to do something and you might have failed the task. And God gives us a second chance to get it right, to edit our lives. We are given do-overs if we fail, because it is not God's will to see any be condemned, but all come to repentance. 2 Peter 3 verse 9 tells us, the Lord is not slack or slow concerning his promise, as some men count slackness, but is long-suffering to usward, not willing that any should perish, but that all should come to repentance, given the chance to edit our lives. You know, as I was I was listening to the devotion yesterday, and I just smiled. I said, God, you are something else. Because I wrote this devotion and I was listening, and I looked at all the topics for the week, and it was Evangelist Victory said, it is a test. Oh God. And then Pastor Ambrose said, chosen to be a credible witness. Then Pastor Irma says, look to Jesus, the author and the finisher of our faith. Hallelujah. And then Minister said yesterday, I can't fight anymore. I have given up. God, you have your way. You take full control. I have given up. And now God says, edit your life. You're given a chance to edit your life. If you're going to be a credible witness, the mistakes that you have made yesterday, you're given a chance to correct it. So if you flew off the handle yesterday, you can go back and apologize. Because many times we do things, and when you come home and you sit down and you think about it, you're like, well, why did I react that way? God doesn't want us to be reactive. He wants us to be proactive. So before you leave your house, pray. Pray that God go before me. God, you know what's lying ahead, because he is the author and the finisher of our faith. He tells us what's lying beyond the bend. We can only see, my friend was saying yesterday, we can't even see the tip of our nose, some of us, much less what lies beyond the bend. I love this verse of scripture when he says, he is the author and the finisher of our faith. Minister Petron was saying, you know, 2017, God made concession for something that was going to happen on May 23rd, 2021. And he says, whatever you're going through today, it's not a problem. It's a solution to something that's going to be taking place in 2022. And that gave me a sense of confidence, because I know that God has a plan. I don't know what the plan is, but something took place in my life this week. And I said, God, I know you have a plan, because I've been telling God, I'm not happy, God. I can't do this anymore. I'm frustrated. And when whatever happened took place, I said, God, you have a plan. It's not the end of my life. Because once there's life, there's hope. It's all about perspective. And God gives us a chance to edit our lives. Sometimes we make decisions because when we are put in a rock and a hard place, we tend to take the first thing that comes along because we are scared. But God says he did not give us the spirit of fear, but of love, power, and of a sound mind. You see, when you have a sound mind, you can make godly decisions, sound godly decisions. Because he said, let this mind be in you as it is in Christ Jesus. When you cultivate a lifestyle where God is the center, where God leads and directs, as Proverbs 3, verse 5 and 6 says, trust in the Lord with all thine heart. Lean not unto thine own understanding. Lean not unto thine own understanding, but in all thy ways acknowledge him. All thy ways. We want to give God a certain part and then say, God, I can handle this. But God wants total autonomy over our lives. God wants to be the one to give us our next move. Faith is not something that you see. Faith is something you act upon. You put one foot in front of the other, not knowing what's going to happen, because what? He says he will perfect that which concerns us. Our God is an awesome God this morning. He gives us a chance every day we open our eyes and take ourselves out of bed when the enemy says, oh, crap, she's up again. Listen, let us realize that we're in the last and evil days, that time is winding down. We got news that a young lady was stressing over work. She went home and she was with her family, and within the hour she died because she had a brain aneurysm and she just died. Beautiful lady, love the Lord, active in the church, doing what she's called to do. But I realize that God is taking home his beloved. God is taking us home one by one, because some of us, if we stay long in this life, we will not make it in. Because the cares of life will press us down. We'll get depressed, disappointed, dejected, and the enemy will work on that and keep pressing us down. But I thank God, he says, even though we are pressed on every side, hallelujah, we have God on our side. We need not worry nor fret, because God has never failed us yet. He is not a man that he should lie, neither the son of man that he should repent. Anything that God has said, he is able to perform. Hallelujah. He gives us a chance to edit our lives. So don't let the things of and the cares of life get us to a point where we get so wrapped up in it that we don't even see or forget that we were saved, we were delivered. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Do not make the return of the Lord take us by surprise on this morning, by the way we are living our lives. He says he shall come like a thief in the night. You see, when you're home and you know a thief is coming, you prepare. You're prepared if you know. Hallelujah. We need to live every day like with the knowledge that the possibility exists that this could be it. Life is a vapor, and we need to know that tomorrow is not promised. So let us make today count. Whatever we do, whatever we say, the word of God says we are the salt of the earth. A city that is set upon a hill cannot be hid. We are the light of the world. Let us not put our light under a candle shade. Let us not put it under a bushel. Let us not hide and be ashamed of the gospel on this morning. Let us be bold. Let us live out our faith. Live it out loud. Everybody's coming out the closet and living out their lives, living it out loud. Well, as Christians, let us live out our faith. Let us not be afraid of man. Let us be afraid of him that can kill both body, soul, and spirit. Man can only kill the flesh. And the word of God says, absent from this body is present with the Lord. Hallelujah. Let us today take a deep dive into our lives and edit where we can. Some things are not in our control, but the things that we have control over, let us make things right. So when Jesus puts in his appearance, He will say, as Matthew 25, 21 states, well done, good and faithful servant, enter into my rest. We want to hear that. We want to hear that. Well done. We don't want God says, depart from me, I never knew you, you work of iniquity. Because you have people set up in the body of Christ by the enemy to distract, to trip up. But we're going to lay aside those things that come to bug us down, those sins that come to easily beset us, because we have witnesses, not only the ones that are passed on, but the witnesses that are in your life. We have live witnesses that have given themselves over to Christ as living sacrifices, so that we can live this life knowing that God has it all in control. God has a way of having things happen. And as you see unfold, when you come to a point in your life, you can look back and say, oh, so God was showing me that, yes, if I do this, this will happen. Listen, all of us don't have to make the same mistakes. Some people think they have to live this life and do it their way and learn from their mistakes. Why? We can edit our life by learning from things that others have done and doing it the right way, not the second time, but the first time around, because we have a cloud of witnesses. Hallelujah. Just be thankful for the persons that we have in our lives that are sold out. Let us pray for them. Let us encourage them. Because it is not an easy road that we travel. But with Christ on our side, it is more for us than against us. I pray that God will give us the spirit of Gehazi so we can see. Open our eyes, remove the scales so that we can see that the host of heaven stands with us. Hallelujah. And we should not be afraid. Hallelujah. Sometimes we are caught between a rock and a hard place. But know this, God always has a plan. He says he will not leave us comfortless and he will not fail us. We are given the chance to edit our lives when we get up every day. Let us make every day count, editing our lives. Father God, this morning, I just want to thank you that, mighty God, you are always on time. You're always having us on your mind, God. Even when we're not thinking about you, you're always thinking about us, making provision for us down the way, oh God. For you're the God that taketh us down paths that we have not tried before, but will cause us to profit in that path. Father God, this morning, I want to thank you for each and every one listening to this program this morning, each and every one that will share the program. And, oh God, it will ripple, oh God, it will cause a rippling effect, oh God, as your people come to realize that you're always a good, good Father, that you never leave nor forsake, that you're always making provision. We thank you this morning for another beautiful day, a day that we have not seen before, but a day nonetheless. We have purpose in our hearts to honor you in all that we do. Father God, in our speech, in what we hear, in what we see, in what we do, oh God, in where we go. Father God, be a fence around us. We pray in Jesus' name. Amen and amen.